Katie Birkwood, the Rare Books Librarian here at the Royal College of Physicians. And today I'm going to show you a few items from our archive and museum collection that relate to the life and work of Edward Jenner. Jenner developed a new way of preventing the disease smallpox. There was already a technique called inoculation in use at the time, in which a patient would be given a small dose of actual smallpox to hope that they would have a mild form of the illness that would then give them immunity for the rest of their life. What Edward Jenner developed was vaccination, a technique that used a different virus, cowpox, instead of smallpox, which was less dangerous but still gave lifelong immunity. Now, Jenner didn't invent this technique. It was already known to farm and dairy workers, but what he did do was write the first scientific paper on the topic. In our library and archive, we have various letters written by Jenner to some of his friends and associates. And there's one of those here in front of me. This was written in the year 1805 to the Reverend Robert Ferryman. When he wrote this letter, Jenner was already a household name due to his invention. Here, he describes himself as vaccine clerk to the world and talks about the incalculable happiness the world derives from my labours. However, the tone of most of the letter is actually very moany, and he's writing to his friend, so he's allowed to moan. He's complaining because he feels he hasn't been properly compensated for the work he's put into the vaccination programme, either by the British government or by any other authorities. He says, "There are many great cities and towns on the continent which can already boast of the powers of the vaccine to such an extent that the smallpox is no longer known among them but by name. Now, have I not a fair claim on the generosity of some of these foreign potentates? I told them how to add to their common stock of happiness in no inconsiderable degree, and asked no price for my communication. It was the immediate gift of heaven to me, and above all price. But common prudence and common sense inform me that with a rising family and a sinking fund before me, I should make some efforts to mend my pecuniary situation." So he's feeling hard done about that. And the other group of people he's complaining about are what we'd call anti-vaxxers today. Today we've had centuries of experience of safe and effective vaccination, and it can be hard to understand opposition to it sometimes. But in 1805, people were still getting used to the idea that being injected with a cow disease was somehow going to make them healthier. And that's a view that's expressed, for example, in the satirical prints of the time. But Jenner is sick of hearing it, and he doesn't mince his words. Although, to be fair, I think he's mostly attacking other doctors rather than the general public. He asks Ferryman, "Did you make a convert of the obstinate anti-vaccinist at Ludlow?" And then later, he makes it clear that these arguments are being had publicly, as he says, "You see by the papers how I'm annoyed by a set of blockheads who write about the imperfection of the cowpox as a vaccine, without any knowledge, scarcely, of its phenomena." And he goes on to explain why these other doctors are wrong, and he, of course, is right. Jenner actually goes into quite a bit of detail in this letter about how the vaccine works, and he even sent with the letter two doses of vaccine, with instructions on how to use them. "I have enclosed two ivory points, the extremities of which have been newly dipped in the vaccine fluid. When you use them, make the usual puncture with a lancet and suffer the points to remain inserted about a minute, when the fluids oozing from the slightly wounded blood vessels will dissolve the hardened virus." It's hard to imagine those lancet blades with cowpox on them being sent through the post, and sadly we don't know whether Ferryman actually tried them out or what results he had. But we do have in our museum collection a set of lancet blades and a holder, these ones here, which may even have belonged to Edward Jenner himself. They certainly have his name on, although we can't necessarily trace the full provenance. If you want to find out more about those blades and the other items related to Jenner in our collections, you can check out our blog online where we go into a lot more detail. And anyone can come and use our research collections here at the Royal College of Physicians. All of our catalogues are online, and you can contact us via email to make an appointment to come and see anything that you need for your research.